Hello and welcome to a new video series at PrivateEnglishPortal.com. My name is Steve Ford and I'm your online private English teacher. We are doing a TOEFL talk series which will deal with the speaking section of the TOEFL as well as the writing section of the TOEFL. Now, before I go into my first speaking section pointers and tips, I would like to tell you a little about my experience as a TOEFL teacher. I first started teaching TOEFL back in 1996, and that was through a school that was licensed to apply the TOEFL test. And to prepare the students, we would receive a little TOEFL book. It was this TOEFL preparation book. It was this little green book with some tapes, and that's all we had to go by in terms of preparing our students for the TOEFL. And of course, that has really progressed over the years, and we've seen many books that have developed as the TOEFL test has developed, from computer-based test to internet-based test. And I've seen many books from Heinemann to Longman to Kaplan to Deltas Key. And of course, some of those books I prefer more than others. And you will be able to find all of that out if you subscribe to my VIP members gold. Little plug there. Anyways, and this test has evolved into what we have now, the internet-based TOEFL test. And what I'm going to focus on in the next few videos is the speaking section of the TOEFL test. Now, we have 6 questions on the speaking section, and the first 2 questions are independent tasks, okay? Now, they are being evaluated by 2 evaluators, okay? And it's been my experience as a proctor and evaluator for the Michigan test that this kind of approach is used also in the TOEFL test, whereby one evaluator will be the good cop and one evaluator will be the bad cop. Okay, now what does the good cop do? The good cop usually is very conciliatory, he's very welcoming, he will try to break the ice with you, and let's be politically correct here, they will try to evaluate your abilities on a more macroscopic level. What does that mean? It means that they will try to evaluate your ideas rather than your grammatical structure, your use of idioms, your use of expressions, so on and so forth. And that is kind of a segue into what I want to say about the bad cop, is that they will pay more attention to your grammatical structures, your use of lexicon, your use of transitions, your use of idioms, so on and so forth. Okay, so that's one very important piece of information to focus on when you're doing that oral evaluation online. Okay, is to know exactly who is evaluating you. Okay, now my second piece of information in this TOEFL talk video is about state and support your opinion. Okay, now one very effective way to state and support your opinion is to try and use euphemisms and to be politically correct wherever you can, okay, and whenever you can, okay? Now, when I say euphemisms, what do I mean? I mean that you try to put things in a very, very politically correct manner, okay? And I can give you some examples. For example, mentally retarded, we would no longer say. We would say mentally challenged, okay? Or we would no longer say mailman, we would say letter carrier. All right. Instead of saying my mother died, it would be more proper to say my mother passed away. These kinds of devices, okay, to use a language which is less offensive to the ear, to the evaluator can be very instrumental in terms of winning the evaluator over and getting that four, that mark of four on the speaking portion of the TOEFL test, okay? So those are my two very important pieces of information, and I will be continuing with my TOEFL Talk series, and I look forward to giving you more information next week. Bye-bye.